God has blended the whole nations together in the kingdom of God. And he has made us all unique individually and unique culturally.
Amen.
And so the beauty of this whole God Belongs My City prayer walk is what you'll see if you have not been if you haven't participated before, but you'll see people from all backgrounds walking together under what? The banner of love.
Amen.
Because when we're in the when we're filled with the love of God, all that separates us is gone. The love of God melts that all away. We see each other completely different. So tonight we're just beginning our coming together that we're going to take place on Saturday. And we're having this prayer rally and just different way to express our worship to God. And Felix and Joanne Martinez have been, and the whole their whole family have been putting this on for the last 4 years. I've been kind of working alongside them and many other people. So I'm going to hand the mic over to them and let things go from here. So Joanne and Felix, whoever.
Good evening, everyone. Hallelujah. I don't know about you, but I'm excited. I'm excited to be here. I'm excited about Saturday. I'm excited about the things that God is doing. In spite of all the gloom and doom and naysayers, we choose to believe in our living God. Amen.
Amen.
And God is awesome and God is powerful. And as the apostle was saying, that God Belongs in My City is about uniting, about coming together as the body of Christ. It's not just unity, but it's the body of Christ. Let me just back up for a minute. My husband is with me and the rest of the Soaring Diamonds crew. I don't know which one wants to come up with me. My son will. This is Mike. Amen. So if anybody knows anything about Soaring Diamonds, we never have a program. Because if we have a program, now we have to put Holy Spirit in the program. And we can't tell him what to do. He tells us what to do. And I like organization. I know some people say, but you have to have some type of order. You have to have organization. And I totally agree. Heaven is a place of order. Amen. And I totally get that. But I've discovered that for us, when we do a program, it's so hard to get out of it. Because now you have this order, and if I don't do it like this, then where am I put this one? And you start thinking about all this stuff, and things get all confusing, and confusing is not of God. Amen? But I'm going to take a moment to pray. We're going to talk to you for a couple of minutes. I'm laughing because I told my son, I'll talk for 10 minutes. You talk for 10. And he said, I said, okay, you're right. I think I said 5 and 5. That was funny. But let us pray. Amen. Father, we just thank you for this opportunity, Lord, to be together, Father God. We thank you for your presence. We don't have to invite you because you're already here. We thank you, Lord, because you are faithful, Lord. And it doesn't matter what we could possibly ever do wrong, Lord, it would not change the way you love us, Lord. We're just grateful tonight. We're so appreciative, Father. And I just pray, Father, that our hearts and our minds will be one, Father God, one in you, Father God. We thank you, Lord, and we just ask that everything that we do, Lord, will bring you glory, Father. For only you are worthy of the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, Mike, you go. We're going to tag team. You go first.
I was just sitting over there, and she's like, you want to go up? I said, and talk? I said, talk about what? And then she just looking at me like, so I look back at her like, and then on top of that, I was just outside getting schooled in basketball by the young boys. So I'm hot and I'm sweaty and this hat's on and I'm like, ah, can't take it off because then my hair be looking like Bozo the Clown. But as soon as she asked me, do I want to talk? The first thing that came to my mind was me and my family like to travel together. Everywhere we go together. Where we ride in 20 different cars, motorcycles, whatever, we're together. Somebody needs gas, we all stop for gas, even if we don't need gas. Somebody needs air in the tire, we all stop for air in the tire, even if only one person needs air in the tire. So we just go to Wawa, take up the entire parking lot just for somebody to get some air in the tire. And then that's kind of like how the kingdom of heaven works. And I'm excited because I was thinking today and I get to decorate my heart with the entire kingdom of heaven. But then I began to understand that decorating my heart with the entire kingdom of heaven, it comes with a big responsibility. And I proclaimed Christianity for many years of my life, like all of my life. But then I didn't live for Christ at all, not even a little bit. And one thing I like about GBIMC, God Belongs in My City, is whether I was embarrassed, whether I was not embarrassed, whether I was new to living my faith out, whether I'm old to living my faith out, it gives you a chance to proclaim your God. It gives you a chance to proclaim his name. He says, Jesus said, just lift up my name and I'll draw all men unto me. And then, so he gives us the responsibility, lift up my name. But all my years, I walked through my life, all my years, middle school, elementary school, because now I look at my son, elementary school, I look at him, you got a responsibility. You have to live for Christ. You know about your Legos, you know about your games, you know, he knows a lot of stuff. He's very intelligent. But when it comes to the things of God and to the kingdom of heaven, we always say, you'll learn. Nah, he could know now. And so I let him know. And so I let him know, you have a responsibility. And I let him know that because it was a responsibility that I didn't live out. And there was this one time me and my whole family was taking up the whole parking lot in Wawa. And we're sitting there, actually on our way to here. We all sitting there and this girl, she pulls up, she's looking at us. I'm guessing she's just looking at us because we always look like we're some type of posse or some gang or something. And then we got our head honcho over there. He always got a bandana hanging off of him. Our other guy over here, he always got that bandana. We look like a bunch of hoodlums. So I'm like, she's probably just staring at us like we weird or something. But then I'm just continuing on, put gas in my bike, go pull over to the side. We're taking up the whole parking lot. Then she comes walking out. Confident and just flowing, like, oh yeah, this people, and she's just staring at me. I'm just like, what is this girl looking at? I'm just confused, like she's just staring at me. Then she yells out my name. She's like, hey Mike. And I'm like, who are you? And then she said it again, hey Mike, you don't recognize me? And I'm like, oh man, I know who you are. And this was my home girl in high school. This is my girl. Like, we used to chill all the time. And in school, I knew I was going to go talk to her, chill with her. We at the same lunch table. We doing different things in school, but we always chilling together. And I recognized her by her voice, but I did not recognize her by what she looked like. And then the Holy Spirit began to speak to me at that moment. You understand this and try to help other people understand this. When you have the kingdom of heaven in your heart, you have a responsibility. And when you proclaimed Christ, you didn't fulfill that responsibility. And that's the outcome. She was the outcome. And the outcome was she was a girl, very intelligent girl, went to college. But then her heart was lost. It doesn't matter how many things you have. It doesn't matter how smart you are. It doesn't matter how intelligent you are. All these things won't gain you joy, the joy of the Lord. None of these things will gain you joy. And it was my responsibility to share with her the joy of the Lord. It was my responsibility to share with her salvation and the love of God and the love of Christ and all that he is and all the great things that he is that I got to experience. But I didn't have no time to share with her. That I didn't make myself responsible to share with her. And here she is, I see her years later, 6 or 7 years later, and she's strung out on drugs. Some teeth missing. She's just completely strung out. What she did for a living, she began to be a stripper. I have no idea why. She was going to college full time. She was a very intelligent young girl. Then the Holy Spirit begins to speak to me. He says, that's what happens when people proclaim my name, but they don't live who I am. And then I began to feel... I was like, dang, that's serious because that's someone's life. God forbid she never gets a chance to hear the name of Jesus again. And that's on me. Partially is that's on me. I know we cannot condemn ourselves. Well, I'm not telling myself to condemn ourselves, but what I am saying is living for Christ comes with a very large responsibility. The better informed you are, the better you are to, the better you can attack something. The better you can attack something, the more informed, the more information you have on something. And I had information about this life and afterlife. I had information about joy, and I had information about happiness and how different they were. I had information about how great or how little the enemy make you feel and who you really are. I had all that information, but I didn't take the time to share it with her. And because I didn't take the time to share it with her, the enemy had his way with her. And then that's what began to all flood in my heart at that moment. And how does this even go to GBIMC at all? GBIMC is not about a specific church. It's not about a specific place. It's about proclaiming the God that you serve. We say we serve God, a living God, the God who can bring change, who we understand his arm is too short for nothing. There is no place that he can't go. There is no heart that he can't touch. There's no mouth that he can't open. There's no eyes that he can't open. And we believe that. Does anybody else believe that, or is that just me?
Amen.
We believe that, right?
Hallelujah.
So if you believe that, then he called you an ambassador. He says, now you are a king among all these people. I'm not going to put on no badge on you. I know who you are because I identify with you by the spirit that I put within you. Now I know who you are. Now it's time for you to let these people know who I am so they don't have to live to all these things that they don't have to live to, that they don't have to be bound by. And GBIMC, God Belongs to My City, is strictly this. People walking and professing and proclaiming, my God reigns. My King reigns. Now you're sick, I know who can fix that. What do you want to do with that information? You're hurt, I know who somebody who can fix that. What do you want to do with that information? Oh, my city is falling apart. Thousands upon thousands of people are losing their jobs. It's affecting everyone in this area. Now, my God provides. Whether you like him or not, my God provides. If you call on his name, he will answer you. It don't matter what you have done. It don't matter what you look like. It don't matter where you come from. But if you call on his name, he will answer. And that's what GBIMC is. We walk through Atlantic City and we release the Spirit of God into the entire Atlantic City. That's what we do. Because there's many people there on the clock all day. Every day, the enemy is not sleeping, terrorizing those streets. And one night, two shootouts, people dead. One night. But then the people of God says, yes, you know, I live for Christ and I'm going to go to church and I feel good. Well, when you only proclaim God inside of a building, it puts people in the grave. And those people are in our hands because we had the information to keep them out of the grave. And so that's what GBIMC is. We release into the air all the warrior angels. That's what we do. We release into the air the Holy Spirit to have his way with whoever he wants because we allow him to. We are the kings. We are the ambassadors. So we have that kind of authority. But many in the body of Christ do not walk around with that authority. Many just walk around. I'm saved. I'm good. I'm going to church. I got my food. I'll help you out. Some McDonald's, man, a couple dollars, it don't really hurt me. But that's not what the kingdom of God looks like. When you decorate your heart, that's not the kind of life we live. When we decorate our heart with the kingdom of heaven, that means everything in the abode of God, everything that surrounds God, it's in our grasp. We have that to dish out to everyone because he has given it to us. Now, GBIMC says, I'm learning how to proclaim the name of God. And if you are someone who knows how to proclaim the name of God, it is, I'm teaching you how to proclaim the name of God. You grab that microphone and you speak his name with authority and with love. And guess what? People are going to come. They have to because it's his word. It's his principle. It's his promise. So GBIMC says, I love God. I'm going to get together with the entire body of Christ. Everyone who hear God's call. I'm going to get together with all of them and we're going to proclaim God's name. We're going to pray and we're going to bring a difference and a change into the city. They got gay beaches. They got all these strip clubs. They have drugs selling in and out of our territory. That's our territory. God made that area. And what GBIMC does, it prepares people to prepare the atmosphere. That GBIMC, that walk, that's just the beginning. But it helps people. It helps people stand firm on their ground. It helps people, it takes away that fear out of the believers. When a young man or a young woman stands on the bulwark in front of a bunch of strangers and proclaim God's name, fear begins to go. Instantly. Fear begins to go. Amen. And then what kind of life does it set up for them after the walk? It sets up a life that brings God into the city because you're in the city. Not because you're hiding in the shadows. No, because you begin to stand out and roar and begin to obey God whatever he says. Because you proclaim, because you help someone learn to proclaim the name of God. And that's what GBIMC is. We get together and we change our world around us. It is not the greatest thing in the world. It is not the worst thing in the world. It's none of that. It's just a place to proclaim God's name into our city. Release the next season. Release his hand. Release whatever he wants to do into the atmosphere. That's what GBIMC is about. And that's why we expect you guys there. Sorry if I took
my Amen. Amen. That was good. So on another side, we just wanted to come tonight to encourage you. To encourage you, and you guys could get ready to come, because I think Michael has said everything that can be said. But just, you know, I spoke, I think it was last week at a church in Egg Harbor City, and I began to speak about identity. And I'm not going to go into all that today, but there's something that I do want to share. After I spoke about identity, and those of us that have been in church for a while now, we know all the scriptures. You know, I am the righteousness of God in Christ. I am who he says that I am. I was called before the foundation of the world, or predestined, I should say. God has my back. All those things that we say. And we know all those things to be true because the word of God said it. But I began to say, how many of us can really say those words? Not just with our mouths, but inside, you know that what the word of God says is true about you. And the last thing I'll say regarding that is that a lot of us say, yeah, I know that scripture, and I am confident in who I am. A lot of times, our family comes off kind of wrong because my girls are just like me. My boys are a little bit, you know, more chill and swag like their dad. But the girls are a little bit more, you know. And I always say sometimes confidence and pride have a really thin line. And I say, you know what? I know. I tell everybody that knows me, Apostle Josh can attest to this. I say all the time, I'm the bomb. I'm all that, a bag of chips. Some bacon on the side, if that's what you like. Some tomatoes, the cherry ones. You know what I'm saying? But it's not because of who I am, but it's because of who is he is in me. Amen? Because the fact that I'm here to talk to you, it's a miracle. And that I will share with you on another time. But it's a miracle, and it's Jesus. And there's something that I discovered, that there is nothing that I or you could ever do. Anything, there isn't anything that I or you could ever say that could ever change the way our God feels about us. It doesn't matter that you cussed, that you didn't go to church that week, that you didn't pray, you didn't read the word, I didn't give, I didn't do, I didn't say. None of that matters. The righteousness that we possess is because of the righteous God that we serve. And there is nothing in this world that could ever change it. And I say, you know what? I know where people are in their walk with Christ by their behavior. So if I come into church and I'm here talking to Dave and somebody says, oh, hi, Dave. How are you? How you doing? And they just keep on walking like I wasn't even there. I specifically said to somebody this weekend, don't assume that because I'm wearing this shirt, I know Jesus. If your sister or your brother knows Jesus, talk to them later. But make sure that you share Jesus with me. Because that might be the only opportunity that you get. So for GBIMC, we're going to take that opportunity to declare that God belongs in our city. And whatever city each individual belongs at, well, that city God belongs in because you're there. And we know that the word of God will be preached, if it hasn't done so already, through the ends of the age, or through the ends of the earth, because the word of God told us so. Therefore, God is in every city. I declare it, I confess it, and I proclaim it so. Amen? So this Saturday, I pray that you come excited as we are to proclaim that, you know what? I serve the King of Kings. I serve the Lord of Lords. And at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, every tongue shall confess that he is Lord. Amen? To the glory of God, the Father. Hallelujah. And my husband wants to say something really quickly, and then we're going to turn up. If you don't know what that means, because this is Praise Tabernacle, we're going to praise the Lord. Amen. And then in that spirit, we're going to go forth on Saturday. Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. God bless everybody. Let's have all the young people up here that love the Lord stand up for a split second. The young people. The word God tells us that we should come to what? To God like what? So why everybody's not standing up? Come on now, come on. We serve a living King, right? We are beautiful. God bless you guys. I just want to say something briefly. It's my passion, it's my desire, and it's a wonderful job, Mike. Wonderful job. To see the seed of God grow so great. I seen this kid grow from a baby to today, and I'm so proud. Now everybody has a responsibility. Just as a coach, I'm not too much familiar. I'm not gonna stand up here and act like I know football, because I was not allowed when I was a kid to even associate with anybody out in the field, because according to my family member, that's people from the world. You can't get involved in that. Anyway, that's a long story. But what I wanna say is that as a coach, the coach's duty is to instruct the children how to play the sport right. Now, for everybody that's here, there's mothers, there's fathers, there's grandparents, there's grandmothers. You have a young person around your life. And our job and our duty, if you see how technology is growing so rapidly in life, when you walk in someone's home, you see everybody's texting, everybody's on their pad, everybody's on their computer. Sometimes there's several people on the table eating dinner and everybody else in their bedroom. See how the transition of life just comes so fast, and we miss out on so many things. You can relate to me, right? My childhood, I remember we had our dinner at the table. Everything was placed to the side. Now I say that because God belongs in my city is for us as coaches, for us as parents, is our responsibility to bring back that love, to bring back that unity among our children, among our family members, among all the good things that sometimes this world brings, as like technology. My daughter Carol, she brought something that's outstanding. One day she said, when we went to a restaurant, everybody put their cell phone right in the center of the table, and let's have dinner, and nobody touch your phone, so that we can have communion with one another, relationship, talk, enjoy each other. Then let's deal about the network later. You follow me? So it's our duty to pour into this new generation, because if we let those old things pass, we're gonna lose out. We're gonna lose out, and we have a responsibility. And if it burns me inside of joy to see kids that are on fire for the Lord. And it burns me so much. This morning I was working at work, and I just felt the presence of God move so awesome. And I know, and the Lord was just giving me a spirit of peace on me. And I said, wow, Lord, I know that this Saturday is going to be outstanding, because the adults that are going to support this new generation, we are going to proclaim the name of Christ, because in Atlantic City is where heaven rests. Amen? Amen? So let's praise the Lord and give glory to God, our living King, a King of Kings, a Lord of Lords, our Alpha, our Omega, our beginning and our end. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen. Yeah, you are free. We're going to sing this song tonight. Woo! I'm going to do the chorus real quick. And I hope a lot of you have heard the song. We're going to do the chorus real quick. The song goes, freedom, 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 freedom.
No more chains, no more bondage, we are free. No more chains, no more bondage. I am free. Yeah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, give them praise, give them praise, give them praise, give them praise tonight. Hallelujah.
We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Jesus. We give you praise, Father. We worship your name, Lord. You are worthy, Father. You've always been worthy, Father. You are such a good God to us, Father. Someone who loves us so much, Lord. Nowhere in the earth, Father, will we find the love that you have for us, Jesus. Nowhere in the world, Father, will we find your grace. We worship you, Jesus. We worship you, Lord. We worship you, Father.
Come on and worship him. Single person representing a family here, representing an area of a city, representing a town, representing the state, Father. We release your name, Father Jesus, over our marriages, over our families, over every person in the streets, over every person in addiction. We release the name of freedom. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus.
Come on, church.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Release it over your life.
Break every chain. 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 Break every chain.
Come on.
There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. There is power in the name of Jesus. There is power. There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. Spirit is telling you to come closer to the altar. There's prayer warriors here.
Jesus, you break everything,
if you feel that maybe what your family's going through, you need a little help from your, from these prayer warriors to help you and begin to pray over your life. Church, this is the moment. There isn't a better place to come to the house of the Lord searching for something. I don't know about you, but I've come to search more of Him. And I need my brothers and sisters to come with me. Amen. And begin to pray with me. And begin to lift me up. And begin to help my wounds. And begin to heal. And begin to pray over my life and prosperity. And the Holy Spirit and His freedom begins to overflow in my life. Come on, church. Oh, we thank you, Jesus. Oh, we thank you, Jesus. Enough. Come on.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
Name above all names.
There is power in the name of Jesus. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain. To break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
The Spirit of the Lord is here.
Yes, we worship you, Father.
The Spirit of the Lord is here. And we're to exude the light of Christ. We're to exude the power of Christ. Amen. Therefore, we need to be completely free. We have to walk in freedom. We have to be selfless. We have to be open. We have to say, Holy Spirit, I want to be used by you. I want to be used by you. Like we heard earlier, we have a responsibility. Therefore, in order for us to fulfill the commission, we need to be free and we need to be empowered. Amen? It's not that you've done anything wrong. It's not that you're in sin. It's not that you're not up to par. But we need to be walking in power. We need to be walking free in order for us to be effective for those that have a need. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you for what you're doing, Father. We thank you, Father, because in you there are no mistakes. I thank you for your sons and your daughters, oh God. I thank you for freedom. I thank you for power. I thank you for anointing and for grace. In the name of Jesus, He's doing something new tonight. Many of you have been waiting. Many of you have been saying, Lord, I need more. There's gotta be more, Lord. There's gotta be more. He's giving you that opportunity. Don't let it go by. Don't let it go by. Hallelujah.
Oh,
my life to worship you. Won't you let this be a sacrifice? Let me dedicate my life to worship you. I'm a lover of your presence. 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 Won't you let this be a sacrifice? Let me dedicate my life to worship you. Won't you let a sacrifice, let me dedicate my life to worship you. I'm a lover of your presence. 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 A passion stirring deep inside. You're the real satisfied to worship you.
I'm a lover of your presence.
presence, Father. We're a lover of your presence, Jesus. Left, and I want the young people to come forth. Hallelujah. Hear you. You're young. Come forth. Don't make me come get you, because I will. Hallelujah. I mean, if you're satisfied with where you are, then maybe this not might be for you. Hallelujah. 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 But if I go back here, would you come closer? If I stand over here, would you come closer? Come right there, right to the front. I mean, if you recognize Jesus, I need more. Jesus, I want more. Jesus, I'm not satisfied. I know there's got to be more. I'm always trying to be cool in front of my friends. I just don't feel confident, Lord. Today the Lord wants to deal with you. I'm not very nice to people sometimes because of the way I feel on the inside. Today Jesus is going to deal with you. He's going to show you his love. He's going to show you how awesome and how much he loves you. This has nothing to do with your mom or your dad or your grandparents or your foster parent or your adopted parent or any other parent. But God, your creator, man, your maker. You have an opportunity tonight. Not because of any of us, but because of him, to leave here different. And I'm not even talking in the spirit. As a mother of six, when I look at some of you, I could see the pain. I could see the confusion. The doubt. What's up with this church stuff? This joint beat. This is whack as hell. I don't even understand it. Why do I have to continue to come here? But tonight the Lord wants to completely help you understand. He's got greater things for you. He's got only good and not harm. To prosper you. To give you a future. You understand that even before your mother thought about you, even before you were in your mother's womb, he already had you in mind. And there's somebody here that could probably say, you know what, my mother didn't even plan me. It was a straight up accident. I was one of those, so she thought. On several occasions, my mom tried to kill me while I was in her womb. But God said, I don't think so. I got other plans. And you know what? Now this is the Holy Spirit. Even some of you adults still have that schism. Ism and schism, like I say. I'm not even sure. Does God love me? Why am I even here? What a waste this life has been. I could have done better. I should have done better. But guess what? Your father says otherwise. He says, I love you with an eternal love. You know, our natural minds can't even comprehend that type of love. We can't. Because I would whoop my child's tail when they were little. Yes, I would. And I would say, call thy fist, because I whoop them and I whoop you again when they have to bring you back. Yeah, I'm from that school. Now ask my kids how many of them actually ever got whooped.
But I say that because sometimes things happen in our lives that give us a misunderstanding of the love toward us. But I just want to tell you, God wants you to know that you are loved. You are loved. You're awesome and you're special to God. And He got great plans with you, for you, toward you.
Standing in your presence, Shekinah glory come down.
And I'm declaring and I'm confessing that after today, you will not be the same. Parents, some of us have made some mistake with our kids. We've messed up. Some of us have messed up bad. But you know what? He loves you, and He loves your kid anyway.
Here we are, standing in your presence.
Your Father forgives you. Your Father loves you. I could say, you know what, Mamita, I'm over you. But I understood that He created me for such a time as this. And if you're here, He created you for such a time as this. Understand, there's, I believe, somewhere around 7 billion people on this earth. I don't know about the outer space stuff. And He thought about you specifically. You might think, oh, I'm here because I just got up and I decided to go to church one day. Negative. He drew you. He wooed you. He pulled you in. And I'm going to pray for every one of you. And what you receive from Him today is totally and completely up to you. He's saying, open up your heart. Forget about yesterday. Tomorrow is not promised. Right now, that's all we get. The only thing that we're sure about is right now, right at this moment. Would you say yes, Jesus? Would you say yes, Jesus? Would you open up your hearts? Will you open up your minds? Would you open up your mouths and say, yes, Jesus?
redemption, Christ.
And you're waiting. Holding up your heart here. You know you want more. You know you need more.
Standing in your presence.
You know you need more.
Glory, come down. Release the fullness of your spirit. Shekinah glory. Shekinah glory.
Have your way, God.
Release the fullness.
Father, we just thank you, Lord. We honor you. We magnify you, Jesus. Can somebody pray with me? Can somebody pray with me? We worship you, Jesus. We glorify you, Lord. We glorify you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Father, we intercede right now for these young people. We intercede. We stand in the gap for every young person here. In the name of Jesus, we stand in the gap. We declare that after today, they will see a difference. They will experience you, God, like never before. We thank you, Father, for every person, every family represented here, God. We say, have your way, God. We say, have your way, God. We say, have your way. Father, as we leave this place, God, we pray, Father, in the name of Jesus, that you will go before us, that we may continually exude your light, oh God, that we may be the body of Christ here on the earth, that we may compel them to come because of the love that we exude, oh God. Help us to be ambassadors. Help us to be ambassadors wherever we may be, God. Wherever we may be, God. Whether we're at work or at school or at the store or at the gym or even at church, God. Help us to be the light. We thank you, Jesus. We're going to continue to pray for whomever needs prayer. We thank you for coming. We just pray that you will stay receptive to the Spirit of God. That you will be sensitive to His voice. And that you will say yes in whatever direction He might lead you. So if there's anybody that still needs prayer, we ask you to come. One of us will definitely pray with you and for you. We loosen the ministering angels. that excel in strength and will go with you as you go toward your homes, your prospective places. And we say, keep your hearts open and your ears to hear from God. Amen. Thank you and stay blessed.
Oh, Hallelujah. We're about finishing. I'm probably going to get in trouble with Pastor Josh. We're like 6 minutes late. But God is good anyway. Amen. Anybody's excited that tonight they were in the house of the Lord? Amen. I know I'm excited. And I'll tell you the truth, I don't even want to leave. I got that problem. Amen. So I hope to see you guys on Saturday. If you need further information, see any of us with the shirts, or Pastor Josh or Pastor Jonathan. They'll have the answers as well. And I thank you, and I hope to see you there on Saturday. Stay blessed. Heaven come down.